Bond, James Bond, is a line immortalized by the silver screen. In 2002, the 20th Bond movie was released, and the event marked a 40-year history of action and intrigue. Over the years, the suave British spy has been played by Sean Connery, George Lazenby, Roger Moore, Timothy Dalton, and Pierce Brosnan, and debate among Bond fans still rages as to who played the best Bond. Both Moore and Dalton attended the premiere of Die Another Day. Even the Queen attended to celebrate the 40th birthday of the celluloid James Bond. More than half the world's population has seen a James Bond film, and it's the most successful franchise in cinema history. The James Bond series of movies has taken more than $8 billion at the box office over the last four decades. In between sipping martinis and chasing villains, Ian Fleming's world-renowned character Bond frequently used boats and other watercraft as part of his endless supply of high-tech gadgets. A favorite is Q's jet boat, featured in The World Is Not Enough. 15 of the power-packed jet boats were actually built for the film, but only 8 survive. One of those on display is the boat that performed the famous barrel roll stunt. The Amazon chase boat used in Moonraker still has its water mines and rocket launchers and boasts real working gadgets, whereas most of the Bond boats had only mock technical capabilities. Bond used the boat, which also contained a hidden hang glider, to outrace his enemies on the jungle river. Tow sleds, underwater towing machines, were used in the 1965 film Thunderball. Originally, 14 were built, but only 2 are known to still survive. Both Bond and the villain Largo used the sleds for underwater getaways. To find another true Bond icon, one must visit Beaulieu Abbey, which has an unbroken ancestral line from the time of Henry VIII to the present owner, Lord Montague. Beaulieu is more than just a stately home. It's the centre of a large and vibrant estate, which has become one of Britain's premier tourist attractions with its National Motor Museum. The now world-famous motor collection grew from this first car, a 1903 Didion Bouton, which was acquired in 1913. And of course, this is the home of Bond cars. This is Sean Connery's Aston Martin DB5. It was also used by Pierce Brosnan in GoldenEye. The Aston Martin nudges bumpers with gold fingers, Rolls-Royce. Other Bond memorabilia is also found here. In Die Another Day, Bond's choice of car was an Aston Martin V12 Vanquish. Bond and Aston Martin have a long history, so much so that John Muirhead of Aston Martin recently implied that the Vanquish took styling cues from some of the more classic Aston Martins, such as Bond's DB5. Bond's V12 Vanquish started life as a concept car and was developed over a 3-year period. When it was launched, the Vanquish was the most technically sophisticated car that Aston Martin had ever produced. It incorporated a number of world firsts in design and construction. One example is the use of carbon fiber in the main body, which offers Formula One levels of crash protection. Recently, Bond's Aston Martin was in a parade of classic Astons. The parade marked the 70th year of the Aston Martin Owners Club. ...600 of the club's 5,000 members worldwide came together to celebrate the enduring appeal of one of Britain's classic sports cars. The oldest Aston Martin in existence, which reached 85 miles an hour on racetracks back in 1921, was also driven at the event, although a little more sedately. It's expected that James Bond and Aston Martin will continue to enthrall us on the big screen.